Some people do kurbani with the sole intention that they're not going to eat the meat of the kurbani. Why? They say, no, we don't like the smell and the quality of the meat is not like how we used to eating from the butcher shop. So, yeah, we'll do the sacrifice of the animal, but we're not going to eat the meat. Not make the intention of the meat alone. And we should not make the intention of not eating the meat. Because we should eat the meat. Qurbani meat is barakat meat. It is meat that is provided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as hospitality. The pious predecessors, the elders, they used to eat the meat of Qurbani on all 3 days of the Qurbani. They used to eat on every day. And they should try to have different varieties of it. Because maybe you get tired of eating it in one style only. So they used to make different types of food, and they used to eat the meat of Qurbani for those days, saying that this is the hospitality of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the meat has been made halal for this ummah. The previous ummahs, they were not even given permission to eat. They were told, do the sacrifice and leave it. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts it, a fire will come from the sky and devour it, and there will be ash left behind. That is it. And if the fire did not come from the sky, that means it was rejected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So from this we can see that this is a favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this ummah, that we are allowed to eat the meat of Qurbani. And when Allah has given us this as a special privilege and a special dispensation, then it means that we should actually partake of the meat of the Qurbani.